Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with news tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi terms Ujjwala Yojana a tool for social transformation, interacts with beneficiaries of the scheme, 45% of whom are from Dalit and tribal communities. Sushma Swaraj hails the government's unprecedented global outreach in 4 years of Modi government, rules out talks with Pakistan, asserting no comprehensive dialogue can happen till the country shuns terrorism. Bipolls held in 10 states of 4 Lok Sabha and 10 assembly seats. Opposition complaints of EVM malfunctioning in Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. Election Commission says reports of large-scale EVM failure exaggerated. Row over Karnataka Chief Minister Kumaraswamy's statement saying he is at the mercy of the Congress and not the people of the state. BJP calls remark demeaning and demands an apology. Tussle over portfolio sharing continues between JDS and Congress. Tamil Nadu government orders complete shutdown of Vedanta Group's Sterlite copper plant in Tuticorin. Decision a week after 13 people died in clashes between police and protesters. Prime Minister Narendra Modi interacted with the women beneficiaries of the Ujjwala scheme through the video conference via the Narendra Modi app. The Prime Minister said that the Ujjwala scheme is bringing about a social transformation by improving the lives of the poor, marginalized, Dalits and tribal communities. The beneficiaries too shared their experiences with the Prime Minister.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that the Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana is playing a crucial role in social transformation. Interacting with women beneficiaries of the scheme through Narendra Modi app, Prime Minister Modi said that out of 4 crore free LPG connections given to poor women, 45% beneficiaries have been Dalits and tribals.
Jo mahilaen ghar ke kaam kaaj ke alawa दूसरी आर्थिक गतिविधियों से भी जुड़ी हुई है एलपीजी ने उनकी कार्यक्षमता अप्रत्याशित रूप से बढ़ा दी है उनका जो समय जलावन इकट्ठा करने में बर्बाद होता था लकड़ी लाना ये लाना डिगना लाना अब वो समय बच गया और उसका उपयोग बाकी जो वो काम करती थी उसमें लग गया.
Addressing the Ujjwala beneficiaries, Prime Minister Modi said that 10 crore LPG connections have been given out in the past 4 years as compared to 13 crores in the 6 decades since independence. The Prime Minister said that 81 families out of every 100 families in the country have the LPG connection now.
Unhone pehle jo diya wo bade bade logon ko diya. Humne tay kiya ki jiske paas nahi hai, jo lakdi ka chula jhalate hain. जो धुएं की जिंदगी गुजारते हैं जो माताएं बहनें मजदूरी भी करती हैं रोजी रोटी कमाने में मदद करती हैं और फिर लकड़ी ढूंढने जाना खाना पकाना इतना कष्ट मां बहनों को होता था हम उनको मुक्ति दिलाना चाहते थे.
The beneficiaries also shared their experiences with the Prime Minister.
सर जल्दी खाना उना बन जाते हमारे घर खाना उना बन गए तो जनसेवा भी कर लेता हूं पान आस पड़ोस में भी बता देता हूं.
उज्ज्वला गैस हमारे घर में आई है इससे हमें बहुत सहूलियतें हो गई रमजान के महीने में तो बहुत ही ज्यादा अब हम सुबह ही उठ के 15 मिनट आधा घंटा पहले ही खाना पका सकते हैं और शहरी में खा सकते हैं और बच्चों को भी खिला सकते हैं सर.
The Prime Minister said that the government is very serious in eliminating middlemen in distribution of LPG connections under the scheme. He asserted that the government has aimed to distribute free LPG connections to 8 crore poor families in the next 2 years. For this, the government has raised the allocation to 8,000 crore rupees. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
On to some more developments. There cannot be any comprehensive dialogue with Pakistan till it shuns terrorism. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj said this on Monday while asserting that talks with the hostile neighbor were not appropriate while people are dying on the border. The minister was speaking to media persons, highlighting the achievements of the India government with regard to the foreign policy.
Addressing a press conference on the NDA government's fourth anniversary, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj outlined the work done by her ministry since 2014. She said the government has achieved unprecedented outreach and unparalleled outcome at the global stage under Prime Minister Narendra Modi's leadership. She also ruled out a dialogue with Pakistan till it shuns terrorism.
We are ready for talks ke saath. Humne kabhi bhi, we were never in a position when we said that we are not ready for talks. But there is a caveat. Terror and talks cannot go together. Ye hamari position hai. Aur is position mein kisi tarah ka koi badlav nahi hai. Pakistan aatankwad chhodkar baatcheet ki mej par aane ko taiyar ho. Kyun? Jab seema par janaze uth rahe ho, to baatcheet ki awaaz achhi nahi lagti.
The External Affairs Minister said Prime Minister Modi initiated a fresh round of talks with China following the Doklam standoff. She asserted that there is no change in the status quo in Doklam and the position of China and Bhutan on the matter continues to exist as before.
ये तीन उद्देश्यों को लेकर हुई थी। पहला उद्देश्य था रिश्तों की सहजता बढ़े। दूसरा उद्देश्य था वैश्विक मुद्दों पर आपसी समझ बढ़े। और तीसरा उद्देश्य था पारस्परिक विश्वास बढ़े। और मैं ये कह सकती हूँ कि ये वार्ता समाप्त होने के बाद ये तीनों उद्देश्य हम प्राप्त करके लौटे हैं। हमने बार-बार कहा है, आज मैं फिर दोहराना चाहती हूँ कि डोकलम के फेस ऑफ साइट पर स्टेटस को बना हुआ है।
Amid America's plan to scrap a rule allowing spouses of H-1B visa holders to work legally in the country, Sushma Swaraj said the government is making all efforts to persuade the Trump administration against such a move.
पूंजी और तकनीक दोनों को साथ मिलाकर इस देश में हम लेकर आए और आज मुझे खुशी है आपको ये बताते हुए कि फरवरी 2018 तक हमारे मई 2014 से फरवरी 2018 तक 209.83 बिलियन यूएस डॉलर्स जिसको हिंदी में अगर मैं कहूं तो 14 लाख करोड़ से ज्यादा की पूंजी फरवरी 2018 तक देश में आ चुकी है.
The External Affairs Minister also added that the NDA government had made the Indian passport stronger while making the process to obtain it simpler.
The 4 years of India's foreign policy has indeed created an impact, and it is talked about not only among the governments of the world but also among the people of the world. And to add to it, the working of foreign ministry has also changed drastically, and the conveniences are going to the people much more easily than it was earlier. Akhilesh Suman for Rajya Sabha Television with camera person Prasanto in Delhi.
And voting for 4 Lok Sabha bipoles and 10 assembly bipoles concluded on Monday amid complaints of EVM malfunctioning from various polling booths from Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. While political parties registered complaints against EVM snags, the Election Commission dismissed the reports calling them exaggerated. Here are the details.
The BJP faced a joint opposition in the Kerana bipole on Monday. The bipole, which was necessitated following the death of its sitting MP Hukum Singh, saw Singh's daughter and BJP candidate Mriganka Singh pitted against RLD's Tabassum Hassan, who has the support of the Samajwadi Party, the Bahujan Samaj Party and the Congress. The opposition is looking to repeat its performance of Gorakhpur and Phulpur Lok Sabha by-elections, where the BJP suffered an unexpected defeat against a united SP and BSP.
Chunav jo Kerana mein ho raha hai, ये चर्चा का केंद्र बना हुआ है. पूरा देश उत्सुक है यहाँ का परिणाम जानने के लिए, क्योंकि एक प्रकार से ये आखिरी उपचुनाव है, आम चुनाव 2019 से पहले का. इस कारण यहाँ पे एक प्रकार का संदेश भी देश में जाएगा जो यहाँ का परिणाम होगा.
इसी गठबंधन पे चुनाव होगा आने वाला 2019 का, और इन्हें जो है ना, जो ये हमारे पे तीन सीटें छोड़ के गए थे, इनको हम तीन भी नहीं देंगे.
Voting took place amid reports of EVM malfunctioning at various polling centres. A delegation of Congress, SP and RLD met the Election Commission officials to lodge a complaint and demanded re-polling in booths where voting was halted for over an hour due to faulty EVMs. The Election Commission has assured that re-polling will be done wherever necessary.
So, Election Commission से हम लोगों ने ये मांग की है कि जहां डेढ़ घंटे से ज़्यादा समय बर्बाद हुआ है, उन सारी पोलिंग स्टेशंस पर कल रिपोल कराया जाए और जहां डेढ़ घंटे से कम समय लगा है, उतना एक्स्ट्रा वक्त 6 बजे के बाद मतदाताओं को वोट करने के लिए दिया जाए।
अपार्ट फ्रॉम टेक्निकल ग्लिचेस इन ईवीएम एंड वीवीपैट मशीन्स, दिस इलेक्शन इन केराना वॉज पीसफुल, बट दिस बाय इलेक्शन ऑफ दिस लोकसभा सीट ऑफ केराना इज बीइंग क्लोजली वॉच्ड एंड बीइंग टेकन एज अ टेस्टिंग ग्राउंड एहेड ऑफ 2019 लोकसभा इलेक्शन फॉर बीजेपी वर्सेज ऑल अपोजिशन।
Along with two Lok Sabha seats in Uttar Pradesh, by-election was also held in Maharashtra's Bhandara Gondia and Palghar parliamentary constituencies and for one seat in Nagaland. In Maharashtra, all four major parties of the state went all out while campaigning, as the outcome is likely to have a bearing on their future course of action. In Palghar, the three-way contest is interesting, with the Shiv Sena and BJP fielding separate candidates. In Bhandara Gondia, the Lok Sabha by-poll was held because BJP MP Nana Patole quit and resigned from the party to return to the Congress earlier this year. While Patole is not contesting the election, he actively campaigned for the NCP-Congress combined candidate who is pitted against the BJP. In Nagaland, a Lok Sabha by-poll was necessitated following the resignation of Chief Minister Nifiu Ryo from the Lok Sabha to contest the Nagaland Assembly election in February. The BJP, which held all four seats, is desperate to retain them as the party's strength in the Lower House has slipped to 272 from 282 since 2014. Assembly by-polls in 10 constituencies in several states also concluded on Monday. These included Palu's Kadigaon constituency in Maharashtra, Noorpur in Uttar Pradesh, Jokihat in Bihar, Gomia and Sili in Jharkhand, Chengannur in Kerala, Ampati in Meghalaya, Shahkot in Punjab, Tharali in Uttarakhand and Maheshtala in West Bengal. The counting of votes will take place on the 31st of May. With inputs from Pancharan Mishra, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, polling for Karnataka's Rajya Rajeshwari Nagar Assembly seat also took place on Monday. The polling was postponed here after the seizure of more than 9,500 voter identity cards just days before the May 12th polls in the state. Despite a JDS-Congress coalition government in the state, the coveted seat is witnessing a tight fight between Muniratna of the Congress and Ramachandrappa of the JDS. BJP has fielded its state secretary Tulsi Muniraju Gowda. Counting of votes will be held on 31st of May. And Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy met the Congress leaders in the national capital on Monday to work out power-sharing arrangement. Meanwhile, Kumaraswamy's statement that he was at the mercy of the Congress party and not the 6.5 crore population of Karnataka sparked a row with the BJP, terming his remarks absolutely demeaning.
Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy met Congress leaders in the national capital on Monday and held deliberations over portfolio allocation in the state. Kumaraswamy exuded confidence that an amicable power-sharing arrangement will be worked out. He reiterated that farm loan waiver was his priority and that he would resign if he failed to fulfill it. However, he reminded people that JDS did not get an absolute majority.
I am in the mercy of Congress. I am responsible for the development of the state. That is different. But whatever I have to do my job as a chief minister, I have to take permission from Congress leaders. Without taking permission from them, I can't do anything. They have given me the support.
The BJP termed his comments absolutely demeaning. The party claimed that Kumaraswamy has become the chief minister or the chief manager of the Congress's ATM machine in Karnataka.
This is absolutely demeaning to the democratic fabric of this country. Bharatvarsh ke democracy aur Bharatvarsh ke lokatantra ke liye यह किसी गाली से कम नहीं है. This is akin to an abuse of the democracy of India.
The BJP emerged as the single largest party in the May 12 polls with 104 seats, just 8 seats short of the majority mark of 112. The Congress party with 78 seats and JDS with 37 seats cobbled up an alliance. The JDS's Kumaraswamy bagged the chief minister's post, with the deputy chief minister's post going to the Congress. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy met Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi on Monday. It was a courtesy call, as it is customary for a new chief minister of any state to call on the Prime Minister soon after assuming office. After meeting the Prime Minister, H.D. Kumaraswamy said that he is committed to waiving off farmers' loans. And now the weather news. There seems to be no respite for people of Delhi or nearby areas as intense heat wave continues to batter the region on Monday. The mercury settled at 44 degrees Celsius in Delhi. As per the Met Department forecast, there is a possibility of thunder showers with strong gusty winds on 30th of May in northern part of the country. But heat wave will prevail in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh through the week. Met Department has also predicted the arrival of southwest monsoons by 1st of June, and heavy rains is in the forecast for Kerala, Karnataka and Lakshadweep.
Uttar Pradesh ka ilaka hai aur jo ki keh sakte hain ki Delhi NCR ka ilaka hai, wahan tapman mein thodi si giravat hogi aur heat wave ki condition agle 3 se 4 dinon mein kam ho jayegi. Parantu jo Rajasthan ka ilaka hai और जो साउथ हरियाणा के इलाका है वहाँ पर हीट वेव कंडीशन अगले 3 दिनों तक बनी रहेगी. साथ ही साथ जो पहाड़ी इलाके हैं वहाँ पर जो हीट वेव की कंडीशन है वो आज और कल रह सकती है, उसके बाद फिर वो कंडीशन खत्म हो जाएगी.
एंड नाउ लेट्स लुक एट द वेदर कंडीशंस अक्रॉस इंडिया. And with that, time for a very short breather. More national and international news on the other side. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Frank Rausen Pereira, at 9:30 p.m.
On this edition of India's World, we will take stock of the Prime Minister's visit to Indonesia and Singapore.
There is much that India could do in the maritime domain, given the number of thousands of islands that Indonesia is composed of, and the issues of maritime economy, maritime ecology.
Singapore and India, we have a multifaceted relationship. It's driven by a great deal of commonalities in the sphere of investment.
Very critical step forward in the consolidation of the Indo-Pacific concept, because which is still under a lot of debate, both right. In the region as also within India. The Indo-Pacific concept would get a boost and India's role would be very well defined.
Of Modi government. How successful has been government's policy of capping the cost of major surgeries?
जहाँ प्राइवेट में आपसे 4-5 लाख रुपए मांगते हैं दोनों घुटने के, वहाँ पे 100 लाख रुपए में सारा काम निपट गया दोनों का.
सरकार जब फायदा दे रही है तो उठाना चाहिए उसका फायदा.
जो पहले स्टंट की कीमत हुआ करती थी 1-1.5 लाख रुपए करीब करीब, उसकी 1/4 कीमत पे वो स्टंट मुझे डाला गया.
ये मरीज बताते थे कि हमें वहाँ पे इतना दे रहे हैं सेम ब्रांड का ही, कहाँ 55,000 कहाँ वो, तो काफ़ी कम हो गया. गवर्नमेंट ने बहुत अच्छा किया. ये तो
एनिलियन के हिसाब से जो दवाइयाँ एसेंशियल लिस्ट में शामिल की जाती थी वो ऑटोमेटिकली प्राइस के कंट्रोल में आ जाती थी.
वॉच 4 इयर्स ऑफ मोदी गवर्नमेंट ओनली ऑन राज्यसभा टेलीविजन.
Welcome back. Now the latest from Jammu and Kashmir, where 3 army personnel, including an officer, were injured after terrorists attacked an army patrolling party at Turkwanghan area in Shopian district early on Monday morning. The blast took place when an IED planted by militants near a water tank went off and an army vehicle passing through the area turned upside down, injuring the soldiers, after which the militants fled the spot and a second IED was also recovered from there. Meanwhile, last night, an army jawan and a civilian driver were killed during a brief exchange of fire between the terrorist and the army personnel in Kakapura area of Pulwama district. Now the news from the national capital. The magenta line of Delhi Metro between Kalkaji Mandir and Janakpuri West was inaugurated on Monday by Urban Affairs Minister Hardeep Singh Puri and Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal. The 24.82 kilometer metro line with 16 stations will cut the travel time between Noida and Gurgaon by at least 30 minutes. With this, the domestic airport terminal, Terminal 1 of the IGI airport, has also been connected to the metro network. The total operational span of the Delhi Metro Rail Corporation network has reached 277 kilometers. At 29 meters, the five-level New Horsecar station is the deepest metro station in the entire network. This section is also the longest stretch to have been opened so far in the DMRC's Phase 3 project. The Delhi Metro is also touting the Magenta Line as a knowledge corridor, as four major universities of the Delhi National Capital Region have been connected on it, including Jawaharlal Nehru University, IIT Delhi, Jamia Millia Islamia and MIT University Noida. The Magenta Line will be thrown open for passengers from Tuesday morning.
Abhi Delhi ka metro jo hai already 277 kilometers tak pahunch gaya hai aur hamare sachiv bata rahe the mujhe ke saal ke akhir mein December 2018 tak दिसंबर तक ये 380 प्लस पर पहुंच जाएगा।
And Aam Aadmi Party leader Kumar Vishwas has tendered his apology to Union Minister Arun Jaitley in the DDCA case. The Delhi High Court has accepted the apology, in which Vishwas unequivocally withdrew all allegations levelled against the BJP leader without any reservations. The apology was accepted by Jaitley's advocates Rajiv Nair and Manik Dogra. The court disposed of the suit in which Vishwas was the only one against whom the defamation suit remained. Kejriwal and four others Aam Aadmi Party leaders, Raghav Chaddha, Sanjay Singh, Ashutosh and Deepak Bajpai, have already tendered an unequivocal apology to Jaitley. Arun Jaitley had filed a 10 crore rupees defamation suit against Aam Aadmi Party leaders in December 2015 after they had alleged financial irregularities in the DDCA when Jaitley was the president. And senior BJD leader and Lok Sabha MP from Odisha, B. J. Panda, has quit from the party on Monday. Panda submitted his resignation letter to the BJD chief and chief minister Naveen Patnaik. In the letter, he wrote that he was hurt and unhappy over the fact that members of the ruling party did not attend the funeral of his industrialist father, Bansidhar Panda, 7 days ago. He said that he would convey his decision to the Lok Sabha speaker soon. Panda has been a parliamentarian of the BJD since 2000 and was a founding member of the Biju Janata Dal. He was suspended from the BJD by Patnaik on January 24th on disciplinary grounds. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu on Monday interacted with scientists of the Indian Institute of Integrative Medicine in Jammu. He said that science has played a major role in the growth of the country and the remarkable achievements in the areas of affordable medicine, food security, milk production, space, atomic energy and information technology, among others, are a testimony to this fact. He said that an integrated approach to healthcare issues is at the core of the India's approach. Talking of his approach, the Vice President lauded the contributions of the first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who said he laid the foundations of the science and technology in the country. He also said that the quality of research is an important indicator of the quality of the educational system.
Research and innovation make us grow. They transform the world we inhabit. In fact, this attitude of researching must become integral to our education system. The quality of research is an important indicator of the quality of an education institution and system. The quality of research in a country's resource institution determines the pace of the country's development.
And now the latest from Tamil Nadu, where the state government has ordered complete shutdown of the Sterlite copper plant in Tuticorin, almost a week after 13 people died in police protester violence. The AIADMK government ordered the Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board to seal and permanently close the copper steel plant. 13 protesters were killed in police firing on May 22nd and 23rd after the 99-day-long protest demanding the shutdown of plant due to environmental pollution concerns turned violent. Now the news from the international front. Former Chief Justice of Pakistan Nasirul Mulk was elected as the caretaker Prime Minister in an unanimous decision on Monday. Mulk will remain in office for 2 months until the country votes the new government on July 25th. The leader of the opposition, Khurshid Shah, announced the decision after 6 meetings with the government and the opposition. The present government will complete the tenure on May 31st and the caretaker government will remain in office until a new government is elected. Mulk is likely to be sworn in on June 1st. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. For more news and updates, keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.